Welcome back to Google Developers Live at I.O. from Moscone here at Google I.O. 2013. I'm Louis Gray from Google Developers Live, and my guest right now is Nicolas Garnier.
Hi, Louis.
On the Drive team, he comes to us from Zurich, Switzerland. So that's quite the trip. Definitely appreciate you coming by. And today we're here to talk about the first year of Google Drive. It's hard to imagine it's only been 1 year, but it came out last year. Last time we were here, we were talking about docs and spreadsheets and each piece in its own little slot. So maybe you can give us a little understanding of what's happened in the last 12 months. How has Drive evolved?
Well, you know, 12 months ago, basically, we launched Google Drive, right? And, you know, people were really anticipating this launch. It's really what people expected, right? It's really a service for people to back up all of the files that they have on their desktop and upload them online and basically allow them to like share these files with their friends, for example, or their colleagues. But really, lots of the effort we have put in, and lots of the groundbreaking features that we've been working on are really related to the SDK of Google Drive. So, the SDK that's basically the API and a bunch of other features that I'm going to tell you about.
And that really sets it up for developers who want to develop against the Drive API.
It's really for apps to really build on top of Google Drive and really use Google Drive as basically, you know, the file system for the web platform, right? You can find nowadays, you know, really cool, really powerful apps online. For example, you know, photo editors, even faxing applications or diagram editors, you know, all of that. So even Google Docs, right? All of these apps that run online that are great editors, we hope for them to actually use Google Drive really as the central place to read files and basically save files too. So that users have like this central place to really hold and manage and organize all of their files, not only the files that they have on their desktop, but really use that for really the web platform, as I said, all of the apps that are out there that needs to save files, that need to read files.
Basically. And you talked about, you look at a differentiation between backup, which is essentially a passive environment where you just send files from one place and put them in another to retrieve later, to more of an active, interactive piece with applications touching those files, sharing with other people. One thing that I've enjoyed is you essentially have, whether it be Chrome OS or any other application, if you log into your account on Google, your Drive documents are everywhere, wherever you follow. And it makes it really feel like any computer in the world is my computer. It's no longer that my files are on my desktop living somewhere. Do you feel like that's really changed the way users perceive it?
Yeah. I think that's really one of the big reasons why people are really moving away from the desktop and doing more and more things online, basically. So alongside all of the cool apps that are available. But to actually, make these web apps, better and make them actually want to use Google Drive as an SDK. We've been launching a bunch of features throughout this year. I can just mention a few ones really quickly. There's now a way for people who have files on Google Drive to publish their files as a website, basically. That's one of the really interesting features. We launched a real-time API allowing apps to build real-time collaboration feature, web apps, right, that are using Google Drive. Collaboration feature that would be similar to Google Docs, for instance. We've seen some really, really cool apps there using that feature.
One of the good things about being on Google Developers Live and getting to see the Google Drive team present is I've seen a lot of these real-time interactive features with the real-time API. Mm-hmm. I've seen a number of the developers out there who have tapped into it for the first time. Yeah. And we've been able to see a lot of the tips, be it Claudio or Steven and the members of your team, talking about how to drive your first Drive apps, be it in Java or C++ or JavaScript. It really seems like the Drive APIs are exceptionally flexible for any type of code that comes in there.
Yeah, actually, most of our APIs at Google have this really wide set of client libraries. We're really trying to make it easy for everyone to integrate with us. I think we have client libraries in 8 or 9 languages, iOS, and Java, Python, PHP, etc., right? JavaScript. And for JavaScript developers, for web apps in general, we're really trying to make it even easier, right? We launched, for example, a bunch of widgets that basically, really common UI components, features of Drive that we don't want, you know, developers out there to have to rebuild everything again, right? So we provide a bunch of widgets to them, like for example the picker, which is like this file explorer, little file explorer they can embed in their website, so they don't have to build that, right? People can just trigger that widget. It's just a few lines of JavaScript, and people can go ahead and select a file in their drive. It's like this little UI popping up. It's pretty nice. We have the same for sharing a file, right? So we allow developers to actually embed that, you know, sharing widgets, the same one we use in Google Docs or Google Spreadsheet or Google Drive, to embed that UI directly into their website. So they don't have to rebuild that feature again.
And so in what fashion would somebody use Google Drive as the backend for their website? You know, I've seen the feature launch, and it's really interesting to understand what kind of actual deployments have you seen so far?
So, you know, I think the best suited apps for this currently are productivity apps. That's really the type of application, online productivity apps, right? That's really the type of application that, you know, can really use the most of our features that are out there, right? For example, I forgot to mention that we have this really, really great feature that was available at the launch of the API a year ago. It's the ability for application to integrate directly with the user interface of Google Drive. So application can basically register just like they would on your local desktop computer. They register to open certain MIME types. They tell us, hey, you know, I can open image. I'm an image editor, so I support opening JPEG and PNG images and stuff like that. So when people are actually installed that web apps or connected, we call that web apps to Drive, then from within Drive, they can, for example, right-click on an image or directly open an image with that image editor. For example, I can cite a few ones, Pixlr Editor or PicMonkey, those are the few cool image editors that you can find online that have a very, very deep integration with the Google Drive SDK, basically, the Google Drive user interface.
And you mentioned Pixlr. They were actually one of the first developer partners that I asked Ali to take a look at. You know, as somebody who uses Chrome OS every day, I want to have the ability to get into image editing, get really deep into it, do the cropping, and all those things that you would do typically with a native desktop application. Yeah. It's been great to see the integration with Drive there, where you can take content that is stored in Drive and pass it right through a system like that. Mm-hmm. Now, we have only a couple minutes. Yeah. I definitely wanted to say thank you very much for coming through and talking with us about Drive and giving us an update on the 12 months of advancements that have happened.
Thanks for hosting me.
Absolutely. I appreciate you coming on GDL at I.O. For those of you on the live stream, we're going to cut over to the sessions momentarily. And when we come back to GDL at I.O., I'll be joined with the team working on games, which were all announced this morning, as you have incredible demos coming up.
All right, thank you.